So as we'll finish up with that when you're done.
Okay, good. This is another very cute story. You're presented your medal, at least we were then, within 10 minutes of winning the event. And after the ceremony, I get the medal put around my neck. I get interviewed by Keith Jackson. Mm-hmm. Keith Jackson became a very special friend, too, because he interviewed me in 68, and he interviewed me in 72. And then we continued a friendship along the way in other ways. But he said to me, I got the medal like this, and I'm looking at it, and he's got the microphone, and I'm half listening to him looking at this thing. And he said to me, he said, the stupid question, you know, don't you hate something? He said, so he puts the medal, and I respect the hell out of Keith, but he puts the mic under me and he says, well, Micki, he said, how does it feel? You know, how does it feel to have that Olympic medal? How does it feel? My mind's racing and I'm looking at this, and he says, how does it feel? And I said, heavy. You know, this thing's heavy, you know? And he recovered for me. He said, indeed, you know, after all the drama you went through from 68 to 72 to win this thing, it's indeed heavy, you know? You know, because stupid question got the stupid answer, and then he recovered, and we laugh about that even today. But after I came off that interview with Keith, somebody came up to me and said, Micki, said, check your medal, because they engraved it before, you know, they gave it to you. I said, engraved it? Yeah, your name's on it. So I looked at it, and sure enough, you've got the little hook there that has a chain on it. On each side of the hook that were words, and I looked, and on one side it said 3-meter diving, and on the other side it said Micki King. My Olympic gold medal, 2 tries, 8 years, gazillion, had my name spelled wrong. What could be, I'm horrified. So when I show it to this person, you know, they said, hey, you know, the little engraving truck goes around from venue to venue to engrave these medals. He might still be there. Maybe you can get him to fix it. I said, gosh, of course. So I go down into the bowels of the pool and find, you know, there's a little trail and little tunnels that take these guys from venue to venue, and sure enough, there's the engraving truck still there to finish engraving the rest of the medals for the evening. So I'm delighted. I catch this guy and I knock on the door of this trailer, you know, and this big German guy opens the door. He looks like Pinocchio's dad, you know, and I tell him, I say, my name is Micki King. And I said, my medal says Micki King. Can you fix? He said, ooh, he's not good. He said, I check. So he goes back to the back of the engraving bus, and he has a little NATO conference with the buddy engraver. And I can hear him talking in German of, you know, with total, you know, urgency. And he comes back after 5 or 6 minutes, holding the medal like this, you know, like it's hallowed, you know, and holding it out, and he said, we decide.
That's really good. I just made
much easier for you to change name than to change medal. And that's when I knew immediately that who cared? You know, the name on the medal is spelled wrong. Who cares? And it's a great story, and it's still my medal, and it will forever be endeared as Micki King.
But it's still to this day has Micki King on it, right?